Hello everyone, today we will learn the passive voice. We can see them active and passive voice. So in English language, that is our total English language book, the chapter 9 is of active and passive voice. Before learning active and passive voice, we should ask one question from ourselves, that why should we study voice, active voice or passive voice? So the first answer which occurs in your mind or which can occur in your mind is that this is in our syllabus, that's why we should study. But that is totally wrong answer. Whenever you are going to learn any new thing in your life, first of all, you should ask one thing from yourself, that why should we learn it? What is the use of it? So here we are learning voice. Voice means active voice and passive voice. In our daily life, we use active voice as well as passive voice. Whenever we speak, sometimes we give priority to subject, or another time we give priority to object. Because in any language of the world, one sentence, one thing, one point, one matter can be talked with two way. That is to say, means in any language of the world, one thing can be spoken with the help of two ways. So we are learning these active and passive voice to say any one thing by two ways. Like, if you say, I have food every day. Or you can say, food is had by me every day. You can say, we celebrate the Diwali every year. Or we can say, the Diwali is celebrated by us every day. So when we give priority to the subject, then that is called active voice. And if we give priority to object, then that is called passive voice. So let's start. Here we'll understand this thing, that in active and passive voice, in active voice, suppose this is the sentence, citizens celebrate the Deepavali with pomp and show every year. I try to highlight the words so that you should understand well. This is active voice. Now you are to convert this active voice into passive voice. How will you convert this active into passive? By the way, first of all, you should try to understand the structure. What is the structure of active voice? If we see the structure of active voice or passive voice, then we can see here, this is the structure of active voice. That is, you will find subject, helping verb and main verb, object and other words. If in any sentence there is subject, helping verb and main verb, that is a complete sentence, that is active voice. And if any sentence, if you find object, helping verb and main verb third form, that can be passive voice. These objects and other words are other things. Like here, by plus subject and other words are other things. These things can be given in the sentences or not. Okay? So you should understand these things. Okay? Here you have understood this thing. There are basic 5 rules to make any sentence from active to passive. How? If you are converting any sentence from active to passive, first rule. First of all, find out the object which is generally given just after the main verb. If it is not given, then start your sentence with it. In any sentence, if the sentence is in active form, then you will generally find object. If you don't find, then you should start your sentence with it in passive voice. Second thing, helping verb is used according to the following table. I made this table to understand well, so that you will be able to understand this thing easily. How you will be able to understand? Let's see. See, if you don't know tense, you don't know the name of tense, you don't know anything, I consider it. But in active voice, if you find is MR, was, were, then you should put either is MR or was, were plus being. Simple. If you find has, have, had in active voice, you should put has or have or had plus been in passive. If you find will or shall, you should put will be or shall be in passive. If you find will have / shall have, you should put will have been or shall have been. If you find main verb first form or main verb first form plus SES or do or does, then you should put is MR. If you find main verb second form or did, then you should put was over in passive voice. You should learn only this rule number 2, and after that it will be easy to you to find out the given sentence is active voice or passive voice. Many of the students try to find out the passive voice with the help of by plus subject. That is very wrong method to find out to passive voice. The simplest, easiest way of finding that given sentence is in active voice or in passive voice, you should learn only this table. If you learn this table, active and passive will be easy for you all forever. You should learn this from active to passive, this, and from passive to active, this. You should learn only this thing. Okay. Rule number 3 is, the third form of the verb is always used in passive voice. This is very good thing. In active voice, we are to put many helping verb and main verbs. But in passive voice, that's good thing that the third form of the verb is always used in passive voice. Fourth is, subject is generally put after the main verb with by me, by us, by them. After the subject, OW means other words are put as they are without any change. So these are the 5 basic rules. You should read them many times to understand. And after that, if you understood the rules of active and passive, then definitely you can understand this thing also. That is active and passive structure. Now you can see, I had tried here to mention the same color, that the rule first was generally beside main verb you will find object. So you should put first of all object, then according to the table you should put helping verb and main verb, then you should put by plus subject here, and other words should be put as they are. There shouldn't be any change. So you should understand these things now, right? So you have understood now. These are some exercises which you can do. Like, there are only 5 sentences. You may, I think so, because you have read everything, you have understood. In first sentence, if we try to understand here, then how we will understand, let's see. First sentence, I teach you English online every day. Teach is main verb. Where is you object? You should start with you, and teach is first form. So you can see in table, rule number 2, here you will put are, you are. Teach is first form, third form of the verb, taught. You are taught English by me online every day. Likewise, you should make these 5 sentences and you should show me. These are basic rules and these are the rules of the tenses which I have explained you today. I hope you would have understood. Still, you feel any difficulty, you should ask any kind of question. Even you can suggest me if my voice is not clear, my voice is not audible, my pronunciation is not clear. If any problem you are facing regarding learning here, then you should suggest me. Because I make these videos every day for you. And if you suggest me, then from next time, I will include your suggestions and try to make better. Okay, so I taught only the rules of tense today, and tomorrow I'll teach you some other rules, like the rules of modals, after that other structures, then the use of let, or we can say imperative sentence, then the use of it, and then the use of there, and narrations. So these are some rules which we will learn in further classes, but this is the basic rules. You should try to learn these 5 rules before learning them. If you try, then definitely further rules will be easy for you. If you don't try, then further rules will be tough for you. Okay, so I hope you would understand it well. Okay, thanks for watching. See you. Bye.